For the families of the three young women who spent a decade in captivity, it's a blessing to have them back.
She has always believed Gina was alive and well. She always believed that, and I just want to say what a phenomenal Mother's Day gift she gets this Mother's Day.
For the victims, now they can begin to live again.
What is the most important thing a victim can do in the days after they are freed, essentially?
Enjoy their families, enjoy their newfound freedom, and be open to support from experts as they're guided on their journey to healing.
John Ryan, CEO of the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, says each year there are roughly 800,000 new kidnappings, and more are in long-term confinement than people realize.
Clearly, there's no formula, there's no textbook on this yet. That book is being written as these cases evolve. And again, it would be different for each individual, but the good and positive news is they do get acclimated, they do move on.
Amanda Berry's new life includes introducing to her friends and family the 6-year-old girl who is believed to be her daughter, born while she was missing. Like J.C. Dugard, who was rescued in 2009 along with two daughters she had during the 18 years she was being held. She and her mother described her struggle in this interview with ABC.
I think I have enough hate in my heart for the both of us. I hate that he took her life away.
And that makes me sad.
I'm sorry, baby. He stole your childhood. He stole your adolescence. He stole high school proms and pictures and memories.
Other former victims have spoken out and started foundations to sympathize and help, like Elizabeth Smart, who was taken by a religious fundamentalist but is now married and advocates for children's safety education.
Not all of them end sad. I'm here. Mine was a happy ending, and I know that there are many more children out there who have the same happy ending waiting to happen to them.
And Sean Hornbeck, whose foundation raises awareness.
When I was 11 years old, I was riding my bike near my home when I was kidnapped by a stranger. I was held captive for 4.5 years. If you see something, say something.
Now, Dugard has her own message to pass along in support of the three newly rescued women. These individuals need the opportunity to heal and connect back into the world. This isn't who they are. It is only what happened to them. The human spirit is incredibly resilient. More than ever, this reaffirms we should never give up hope.